Ever wondered how the internet works? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you a top-level overview of how the internet that you use every day actually works. Stay tuned. Alright, so we use the web every day, but let's take a look at how it actually works. So on your computer, you have a web browser. And whether it's Internet Explorer, Chrome, Firefox, they all have one thing in common. And that's they have an address bar. So you type in that URL, you press enter on your computer, and you know, within a second or less, you get content on the page. But in that second or two, there's a lot that has to happen. Well, the first thing that has to happen is, let's use my site for example, techtipguru.com. Let's say you want to go to this website. Well, where is that website? How does a computer know where to find that? And so the first thing it has to do is it has to go to a DNS server. A DNS server is the domain name service. And basically what it does is it resolves a domain name, which is just a domain. And so a DNS server has the domain name and the server's IP address. Now there's lots of DNS servers, and so it's the job of your ISP to be able to forward that request to a proper DNS server. So you go to the site, your ISP says, okay, great, here's a DNS server, and the DNS server goes, okay, you want to go to techtipguru.com? Perfect, here's the IP address. And it'll give back an IP address of where that server is. So now that you have the IP address, your browser has to do a get of that content. And so this is where the HTTP or HTTPS protocol comes into place. And your computer goes, great, go to this address with this protocol and get the content for me. Well, now we have another problem. Where's this IP address? There's a lot of servers, there's a lot of computers in the world that this IP address could be. It would take forever to go to every server in the world and be like, hey, is this your number? Nope. Okay, is this your number? Nope. So instead, there are services set up throughout the internet. And so you have your ISP, and your ISP is going to report back to a higher level, kind of a cross-country or even international type connection. And those in between that, it's going to be bouncing along multiple servers. So your request goes to your ISP, and your ISP is going to go, okay, well, let's go to this server because this server is, you know, pretty close. And then at some point, it'll go to a server, and that server is going to be like, ah, okay, I know where you need to go. You actually need to go to the server over here. So it's going to send you there. And then this server goes, yep, yep, you're getting close. Server you want is right here. And so it finally gets to this server. And then this server, assuming it's an actual website, gets the request from HTTP, which is actually made on port 80, unless it's HTTPS. If it's HTTPS and it's port 443. Not that you necessarily need to know that, but it's interesting because this server, here, we'll keep drawing over here. The web server will get that request, and I go, oh, you want to get to this website? Well, perfect. Let me give you the file or the main homepage for that site. So this server has to do some work, and it has to go, okay, let me find that file for you. Great. Here's the homepage. And so it'll come back to your browser, and it'll show you that homepage. So there's a lot that has to happen in the world of the web. And so sometimes, you know, and I do this too, I get frustrated with the site taking so long to load, but then it's amazing when you actually look at and think about how much is actually happening and how these computers are communicating through servers all over the world and rerouting and how optimized these things actually are. This is also why sometimes in your area, One service may be running slow, or a website may be down for you but not for other people, and sometimes that's because there's a break in one of these lines, one of these connections. And so when that break occurs, well, if there's a break here in this connection, well, this server has to go, oh, well, I'm not sure where to go, so it has to take a moment to recalculate, and it may jump across, you know, multiple other servers until it can go, okay, now I've established a new connection, so then it maybe can reconnect, well, probably not directly, but maybe it can reconnect in a couple less trips. Anyways, so this is in general how the high level view of how the internet works, how it takes what you type into a web browser and gets it actually to the server that has the website and gets it back to you. I'm going to do another video on how a website works. And so if you want to watch that video as well, I'll have a link on the screen as well as in the description to watch that video once it's ready. And we'll go more into the detail of how an actual website actually works and processes your information. What happens in this moment here when the request comes in, when you're requesting the website from the server, in between that and when it actually sends the information back to you. So I hope you enjoyed my video on how the internet works. I love talking about technology and these kind of things. And so if you'd love to see more of my videos, I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel. Click the subscribe button below. Or if you want to check out my website at techtipguru.com. I have a forum there where you can sign up, make an account, and ask a question. And maybe I'll answer it on one of my future videos. Again, thank you for watching.